Hello everyone, welcome to the Sandpoint Belagavi. Today in this particular video, we are going to solve the questions of the transportation engineering which were asked in the year 2017 in the WRD exam. So there were total 5 questions. 4 questions came directly from the highway engineering and one question or the one numerical was from the airport engineering. So let's start. Here we have our first question in which we have to select the options based on the correct formula for the super elevation. V is given as the design speed in kilometer per hour and R is the radius of the curve on a hill road. Now for solving this question, there are two formulas which can be utilized. So the first formula is E is equal to V square upon 225 R. And the second formula for super elevation is E plus mu is equal to V square upon 127 R. Now the confusion arises, which one is the correct one? So if I talk about the first formula is utilized when we are designing the super elevation. So for the design of super elevation, we'll be utilizing the first formula. Now the design of super elevation has been suggested by IRC. So whenever we are going to design it, we have to consider the speed of the vehicle or the design speed as 75%. We are going to reduce it. At the same time, we will be considering that we have the mixed traffic condition. So for mixed traffic condition also, we will be using the same formula. Now what is mixed traffic condition? Mixed traffic condition means we have slow moving vehicle. At the same time, we have the fast moving vehicle. So that's why IRC has suggested that we will be reducing the design speed to 75%. At the same time, they have said that the mu value, the friction coefficient will be considered as zero. That means the entire centrifugal force will be taken care by only the E value, that is the super elevation. There is no role of the friction in counterbalancing or counteracting the centrifugal force. While the second expression that you see here, that is the basic expression that we get from the derivation. So this second expression, this is used when friction value is given to us. So whenever coefficient of friction mu value will be given to us, we'll be using the second formula. So let me write the condition when we will be using second formula. So here I am writing when coefficient of friction is given in problem, or it has been said that we are utilizing the friction or we are developing the friction of this much coefficient, that time we'll be using the second formula. And if it has been asked, you have to calculate the rolling minimum radius. Rolling minimum radius. Then also you will be using the same formula. While calculating rolling minimum radius, we will keep the value of E as 0.07 and the value of mu as 0.15. So if we put E and mu values as these, then whatever value of R we are going to get, that will be called as rolling minimum radius, because R value will be minimum when E and mu, they attain the maximum value, and they will attain the maximum value of 0.07 at 0.15, which are again suggested by IRC. So now coming to the options, which one will be the correct one? So here they have asked about the super elevation, that is the value of E, and there is no mention of mu here. The mu means the coefficient of friction is not given to us. So that time we know that the correct formula will be the first formula, because mu we are not considering, and based on that we are calculating the super elevation. So the correct option for this will be option 3, V square upon 225 R. Now the second question that we have is again based on the same formula which we have talked just now. So here again, clearly it's mentioned that we have mixed traffic condition, the rate of super elevation we have to calculate, radius of the curve is known to us, and the speed of the vehicle is also given, that is the design speed. So again, I know that if it is a mixed traffic condition, directly we can apply the formula as V square upon 225 R. And now we can substitute the values. So E is equal to V square upon 225 R. So on putting the values, it becomes 100 square divided by 225 multiplied by 500. So on calculating this, the answer will come out as 0.0 8888. That means it is somewhat closer to 0.089. This can be written as 0.089. So this is our final answer. So going by the option, the correct answer will be option 2. Next problem is, what is the value of resultant retardation that we are going to observe when the longitudinal friction coefficient is 0.36 is allowed for stopping the vehicle on the road? So let's make a diagram for this for a better clarity. So suppose this is my vehicle which is moving on the road. This is our vehicle which is moving on the road. And here we are applying the brakes. So on application of the brakes, it is going to retard. It is going to retard. So it is not acceleration, rather it is deacceleration. So it is going to deaccelerate. So now suppose when it is deaccelerating, some force will be acting in the forward direction. And the magnitude of this force is say F. The magnitude is say F. And this F can be written as mass of the vehicle multiply by the retardation or the acceleration, we can say. At the same time, a frictional force will be acting in the backward direction. Frictional force. And this frictional force is nothing. It is mu multiply by capital N, where N is the reaction that we are getting from here. And N is nothing. N is equal to M times of G. M times of G. So now let's consider the equilibrium condition. And using that condition, we'll be able to calculate the value of the retardation. So now I can equate that this F is equal to FF. So I can say that M into A, mass into acceleration or deacceleration, is equal to mu times of N. And this N is nothing, it is equal to mg. This N can be written as M into G. So from here, M and M will get cancelled. So A equal to mu times of G. So let's put the value now. So mu value is given to us. That is 0.36. And G we already know 9.81. So let's multiply them and check what answer do we get from here. So on calculating, the value that you are going to get is around 3.53 meter per second square. And if we go by the option fourth is correct option. Let's discuss about the next problem now. They are asking about the Nagpur road plan. So there are certain facts about this plan. This was the first road plan of India, first 20-year road plan of India, which was there in year, started in 1943, and it was supposed to end in 1963. But somehow it got over in 1961 only, 2 years ahead of the schedule. Now under this, the road development happened in India. And the classification of the road was done into 5 categories. So the correct answer for this is option 2, 5 categories. Now let's understand what are those 5 categories. So the first category was National Highway. Then we have State Highway. Then we have Major District Roads. Then Other District Roads. Last is Village Roads. So these are the 5 categories of the roads which were classified under this Nagpur plan. Then in the other plans, one we have Bombay plan, then we have Lucknow plan. Under them also, the road has been classified. Like if I talk about the Lucknow plan, under that we have 3 types of roads. Primary roads, secondary roads and tertiary roads. So something like that, the classification has been done. So the correct answer for this one is option 2. Now coming to the last problem, which was asked from the transportation engineering. So this particular question is from the airport engineering. So in this, what they are asking is, we are asking about the airport reference temperature. So let's understand what is the formula for that. It is numerical based. Directly we have to apply the values here. We have to put the values and get the answer. So airport reference temperature formula I am writing. So let's say that capital T is the airport reference temperature. So it is calculated by TA plus TM minus TA divided by 3. Now what is this TM and TA? Let's understand that. So TA is equal to, so TA will be called as monthly mean of average daily temperature of hottest month of the year. Hottest month of the year. And TM is monthly mean of. Monthly mean of. Maximum daily temperature of the same month. Of the same month. So let's understand what is the difference between this TA and TM. So first of all, in the entire year, we have to pick the month which is having the hottest temperature. The hottest month we have to select. So suppose in particular year, say year it was say 2020. In this 2020, say May month was the hottest month. The maximum temperature was recorded during this time. Now what will be TA? TA will be the mean value of all the 31 days. May is having 31 days. So every day we are going to calculate the temperature and we are going to take average of that. Average temperature means suppose on 1st May in the morning, the temperature was say around 30 degrees Celsius. Then in the afternoon, it reached say 45 degrees Celsius. Then in the evening, again, the temperature will dip. So it was say around 28 degrees Celsius. So we have to take average of all these values. I have taken these three values only, but on hourly basis, we can have 24 values. So we'll take average value of this. Then on the second day, 2nd of May, we'll do the same analysis again. We'll take the average of the entire day. Same way we have to do for all the 31 days. We'll take the average value. Then again, we will take the mean of all these values. So whatever value we are getting for each day, we'll take the mean value of that. So that is our TA. Now what is TM? TM is the mean value of entire month, same month, which we have taken as May month only. Now we have to take the average of the maximum value. Suppose on the first date, the maximum temperature was 45 degrees. On second date, the maximum temperature was say 45.5. On third day, it may be 46 degree, it may be 44 degree. So whatever is the highest value, we'll pick that value. And for every day, we will take the mean. That means for the 31 data that we are having, we'll calculate the mean, we'll get the value of TM. But in this numerical, we do not have to do much because directly this TA and TM values are known to us. So here TA is given as 30 degrees Celsius. It is the mean of the average temperature. And 45 degrees is the mean of the maximum daily temperature. So when we are going to take average values, we can directly substitute that in the formula. So TA is 30. Then we have TM. So 45 minus 30 divided by 3. So on calculating, this comes out as 35 degrees Celsius. So that is our option 2. So these were the 5 numericals which were asked from the Transportation Engineering WRD exam in year 2017. So I hope this video was quite helpful for you in understanding the type of questions which are asked and also to know which topics are more important from the exam perspective. And now the exam is quite closer. It's in the next week. So all the best to all of you. Thank you.